Hello, as in unit 3 you can see we have now 3D graphics, that is 3-dimensional concepts and object representation. Before we did 2D, dimensional view, clipping and all. Now we have 3D graphics. In 2D graphics we have 2 dimensions, x and y. In 3-dimensional geometry we have 3 axes, that is x, y and z. Done. So we have now 3-dimensional representation of the objects. So here we are using 3-dimensional representation for solid objects. So we can use either boundary representation or space partitioning. In boundary representation, we can separate object interior, and in space partitioning, we can describe the interior properties of any object. Done. So we have 2 methods for the representation of solid objects, that is boundary representation and space partitioning. So first we will discuss in this video boundary representation, and using this we have polygon surfaces, that is boundary representation. Here we use this for the representation of 3D graphics object, and it contains set of polygons that includes object interior. Done. So first we have polygon table. In polygon table, information of each polygon is placed in the form of table. Done. Now we are using here tables in order to show the information of each polygon. Done. We have 2 further parts. We can use geometric table, attribute table. In geometric table we have, they contain vertex and parameters for the identification of orientation of the polygon surfaces. And for attribute table, they contain the attribute information of the object. So for example, we have this one. So how we can represent the geometric data for this? So first we have vertex table like this. For example, you can see here we have 5 vertex: v1, v2, v3, v4, v5. Done. For the first vertex, you can see we have 3 axes, x, y, z, and we will denote these coordinates with x1, y1, z1. As in 2D, we have x, y, now we have x, y, z. That is x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2, and so on. So for all vertex, you can see we have 3 dimensions. Next we have edges. We will represent the edges with e1, e2, e3, e4, e5, e6. Done. For edge table, how we can draw the edge table for this? For edge e1, check the vertex, that is b1 and b2. For edge e2, here you can see here we have vertex b2 and v3, that is here v2, v3. For edge e3, that is here we have v1 and v3 vertex. For edge e4, we have v3 and v4. For edge e5, we have v4 and v5. For edge e6, we have now v1 and v5. Done. So this is the edge table, and here we have the vertex table. We have 5 vertex, 6 edges. Now we have polygon surface table. So right now you can see we have 2 surfaces, S1 and S2. S1 can be represented by 3 edges that we are using here, that is E1, E2 and E3. Done. For this surface we are using 3 edges, E1, E2, E3, and for S2 we have E3, E4, E5, E6. So this is the polygon surface table. Done. So for this we need to compute vertex, edges, and after that, so why we were using polygon surface table? For the boundary representation. Done. So we have 2 surfaces in this polygon, S1 and S2, that can be represented by the boundaries like the edges. We can represent these 2 by the boundary. These two surfaces of this polygon can be represented by the edges like E1, E2, E3, and for this we have E4, E5, E6, E3. So that's all about this video, that is polygon surfaces table. In next video, we will see the next topics, and if you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching.